それでは定刻となります。
We will now like to start the 2018 Midterm Management Plan announcement by Hitachi Limited. I would like to introduce the speaker for today, Toshiaki Higashihara, President and CEO of Hitachi Limited. Mr. Higashihara, please. Good morning, everyone. I would like to explain the 2018 Midterm Management Plan. These are the contents that I would like to cover today. First of all, I would like to talk about the summary of the 2015 Midterm Management Plan and the direction for the future. This is the result that was announced on the 13th of May. Revenues have exceeded 10 trillion yen. However, in terms of profits, we were not able to achieve the original plan. It is unfortunate. However, on our part, we have been able to maintain and secure operating margin of 6%. Therefore, we believe that we have a certain level of staying power. Now, from 2014, we have been emphasizing cash flow management. As you can see, we are showing results. In the past 3 years, we have been promoting the social innovation business. As you know very well, social infrastructure and IT are to be combined so that higher level social infrastructure can be provided to society. We believe that the major direction is correct. And in the coming 3 years, we will make concentrated investment in the area of social innovation business. Let's look at the past 3 years. The Ansald has been acquired, and Pentaho acquisition has been made. And in terms of revenue, it has pushed up revenue by 600 billion yen with these acquisitions. But with the capital alliance in terms of thermal power system as well as overseas air conditioning system has led to sales decrease of 900 billion yen. And we had capital alliance for logistics as well as the financial business. And this will push down the revenues by 1.1 trillion yen per year. But a reduction in revenue is not something that we should be overly concerned about. We should be promoting business structure reform without fail. We must also reflect on the following. In the overseas projects, project management was not done thoroughly, and there were some losses incurred. Accordingly, we have to reflect on this. We must focus on areas of specialty going forward as a countermeasure. Now, in terms of network and telecommunications storage, changes were occurring in the market. However, we were not able to respond in a timely manner. In order to deal with this, we must make further efforts in terms of acceleration of management. Next, I would like to talk about what we are aiming to achieve in the 2018 Midterm Management Plan. Let's review once again the characteristics of Hitachi. OT, comprising control operations as well as IT and products and systems. These can be provided by one company, and I think it is very rare, even in a global perspective. Therefore, these characteristics must be brought to the fore in terms of business, and that is my desire. Next, let's look at how the world is changing around us. Let's review this flow. Customers' viewpoint is changing, moving from products to outcomes. So value is being emphasized. There is a transition from ownership to sharing. Car sharing is a good case in point. There is transition from closed to open. Open innovation is emphasized. And we are moving from individual optimization to overall optimization. And this trend is becoming more accelerated with digitalization. If we look at the world around us, digitalization is making advances. And society, as well as the industrial structure, is undergoing change. It is indeed a paradigm shift that is besetting us today. Against this backdrop, we have to consider what Hitachi can do. I will give some examples of this. The social innovation business have been emphasizing individual optimization utilizing ID so that higher level systems can be provided. But going forward, Hitachi will utilize digitalization technology to connect these points. Logistics companies example can be provided here. The plants was optimized using IT within the plant. But e-commerce as well as settlement system as well as logistics will be connected. All the points in a supply chain will be connected for overall optimization. Hitachi will utilize digital technology to link these points. Next is the context of urban. So far, we had buildings, developers, rail operators, and usually companies, local governments receiving individual systems from Hitachi. But Hitachi will connect these together so that overall optimization solutions can be provided. For example, the flow of people can be monitored to control the schedule for operations for transportation, and energy optimization will be enabled. Digital signage can be provided at shopping malls, which is another example. By utilizing digital technology, quality of life can be enhanced. Now I'd like to talk about the specifics of 2018. Hitachi is aspiring to become an innovation partner for the IoT era. To accelerate the collaborative creation with customers through the advanced social innovation business. That is what we are aspiring to become. There are four focus business domains: power, energy, industry, distribution, water, and urban, as well as finance and public healthcare. I will now like to talk about how we will strengthen the social innovation business. So let's review Hitachi's business today. The vertical axis are the level of collaborative creation, whether it is open or not. The horizontal axis is whether we are providing to individual customers or a multiple number of customers. In other words, scalability is shown. For Hitachi's business today, we have industrial equipment as well as elevators and equipment, materials. We also have in the area of finance the accounting system as well as public systems. Our system integration functions are provided. On top of that, we have the construction of power plants as well as railway business, which is large scale. With the trend toward digitalization, it will move to the right-hand top side. It is moving toward the digitalized social innovation business. In terms of people flows, the elevator can be controlled, and the waiting time can be minimized, and power energy conservation can be enabled. In the UK, the train cars will have sensors, and information will be collected, and preventive monitoring can be enabled, so that the utilization rate can be enhanced. These are all enabled by digitalization. With digitalized technology, there will be further connectivity, and a high value can be added. There will be further evolution toward the right-hand top. This is the direction for us going forward. against this backdrop, what is going to be important is to have an IoT platform. And on the platform, or based on the platform, we must work together with the customers to resolve problems and come up with solutions. This is the ability of the front. This IoT platform and the front ability must be strengthened. This will be the key. Therefore, from the 1st of April, we have changed the organization significantly. In the past, based on products and technology, we had the in-house company system. This has been reorganized into the front team, the platform team, and the product team. It will be realigned into three tiers. The front team will discuss issues with the customers, identify the solution, and identify solutions. Platforms and products can provide the support to the front side in terms of providing the platform as well as products. Now, in this regard, IoT platform is going to be extremely important. On the 10th of May in Silicon Valley, a global launch was made for the IoT platform, which is called Lumada. It is analytics to analyze big data, and AI are the basic functions. And on top of this, energy solutions and urban solutions can be provided. So it is a platform. There are four characteristics of the platform. One is that there will be a single platform or multiple solutions. This is regarding relevance, has relevance in terms of digital connectivity. The second characteristic is that it is very open. Partners can be connected through this open environment. There are many cases where customers have data in many forms. And we will use the symbiotic autonomous decentralization technology of Hitachi to connect these data so that valuable analysis can be made. Bringing to bear that is knowledge and experience, we can provide a secure platform for our customers. This platform, Lumada, is very much in line with the Society 5.0, which has been promoted by Japan today. Cyber physical system foundation is what can be provided through Lumada. On the other hand, we have to strengthen our front organization. Sales, system engineers, consultants are included in the front. This is a team that will be facing the customers to provide solutions. Currently, globally, we have 110,000, but this is not enough. In 3 years, we want to increase by another 20,000. At the same time, we have to change the mindset of the people within Hitachi. We have to be able to better understand the issues facing customers. We have to come up with better solutions for our customers. So in order to achieve this, we have started a new training program. In 3 years, 19,000 people will be subject to this training. And this front strengthening has started from 2015.
And in three tiers, we are creating Global Center for Social Innovation for the front. Worldwide, we have 550 people involved in this to create innovation for our customers. That's one. And this has already begun. And this time, we changed the organization so that such an effort can be pushed for on a company-wide basis. And products are going to be important as well. Products will change, too. This bar chart shows automotive parts, escalators, elevators, and industrial
products, 1.8 trillion, a margin of close to 8% is being achieved in these businesses. So in the trend of digitization, products are going to be connected with each other through digital technology, and that's the kind of products we would like to offer so that products can be strengthened. On a global basis, starting from April last year, we have set up a position for regional chief executive outside of Japan in four regions. There's a regional chief executive promoting the social innovation business in each region. For railway business, which is very active in the UK, we have set up a headquarters for the rail business in London, and it's been head up by the person there. And for platform, we have headquarters in the United States, San Jose. Now, next, on strengthening the management base. Speeding up the management, that's very crucial. For that to happen, the question is, how can we collect information from the people on the ground so that we can make quick decisions? So we have to be able to translate our employees' voices to the top management policy. That's my responsibility. And so increasing the speed of management is going to be my responsibility, and we'll have to continue to reduce the layer of management for that. And in terms of global rollout, centering around regional chief executives, we will work with the local and regional customers and partners. They will be increasing number. And with respect to business profitability, there are business areas where profitability is still low. We still have them. Fiscal year 2016, I have given instructions that these must be reviewed thoroughly. We need to take measures for low profitability business. And at the same time, the investment that had been made in those areas should be switched to areas that are growing. And it says here, evolution of Hitachi smart transformation. We've been doing this between 2012 and 2015. And as I will say later, we would like to further evolve this. And investment in growth. In 3 years, we're going to make an investment of 1 trillion yen. Now, this is about the evolution of Hitachi Smart Transformation. 100 billion yen of cost reduction per annum. That's been what we've been pursuing so far. But price competition has become harsher. And the sales price have come down. However much we reduce our cost, it's become hard to catch up in terms of cost reduction. So we need to once again review our cost structure. SG&A and gross margin. In each business, what are the levels we need to take a look at? And in 3 years' time, what levels do we need to achieve? And we need to drastically change that. If revenues come down, then the cost needs to be brought down as well. And that is the kind of smart transformation that we would like to continue to implement. And working capital efficiency, in terms of that, CCC is improved quite substantially, but there's still room for improvement. Visualization is being made. So we need to take a step further to reduce inventory and lead time. And plants have their own assets and equipment. They see it as their own equipment and facilities, but they can be shared by other plants. So from that perspective, we would like to further promote the sharing of production facilities among plants. Lumada that I talked about earlier, by introducing Lumada, AI and analytics, by utilizing them within smart transformation, we would like to utilize the platform, leverage a know-how to produce solutions. Perhaps we may be able to offer such solutions to our customers. So
We would like to engage in production reform utilizing Lumada first and foremost. Now, this is our thinking regarding investment. For the front and the platform, well, the platform will have in-house development, and for the front, through acquisitions, we would like to manage a number of businesses. For products, is it a product that we would like to grow on our own, or is it a product where we would like to collaborate with other companies in terms of capital alliance so that we can have a better chance at winning globally? So those are the thoughts that will go into our capital policy, investment policy. Now, I would like to provide you with a vision for fiscal year 2018. These are segments that are slightly different from the ones that are published. Just to give you an image, what is the size of the front? What is the size of the platform? What is the size of the products? That is what is roughly shown here to give you a flavor. For the front, power and energy, in the next 3 years, the revenue is not expected to go up all that much, but we would like to change the profit structure so that it becomes more profitable. For industry, distribution, water, not a great change is envisioned, but we would like to improve profitability there as well. For urban, railway business is expected to grow, so revenue as well as profit are expected to grow here. And finance, public, and healthcare. Revenue may not be brought up very much, but profitability is going to be important considering the volume of this business area. Now, which areas are we going to focus on? This is a summary. In power and energy, utilizing IT, distributed power supply is going to be promoted. So a focus will be in microgrid and so forth. And for industry and distribution, as I said earlier, on top of Lumada, the platform, industrial applications will be built and provided. For urban, a growing railway business is a given, that's obvious, but urban solutions utilizing digital connections so that quality of life can be improved, that's the kind of business we would like to deploy. And finance, public, and healthcare, fintech, my number, healthcare services, it says here. Modalities, therapies, there are many. Hitachi has a strength in IT, and so IT-based healthcare services must be expanded more. That's what we aim at doing. And for our platform, we will continue to brush up on Lumada. For products, industrial products, materials, businesses will be expanded. This shows the global revenue. For Europe, because the expectation is that railway business is going to be grown, this is going to be what we envision. And on top of storage, energy, healthcare, and so forth, that will be provided in North America. For China, elevators, escalators, ATMs, we offered many products, but I think the product mix will change and there will be a lot more solutions included. So although revenue may not grow all that much, but the product mix and the service mix will change. For Asia, we're talking about transformers business in Myanmar. Industrial equipment and finance businesses are expected to grow. And overseas revenue ratio is to grow to 55% in fiscal year 2018. So this is a summary of the numbers. In terms of front business expansion, front revenue ratio of 40% will be aimed at. And for global business expansion, the target for overseas revenue ratio is 55% or over. And to strengthen cash generating capability, we have set a target of operating cash flow margin of over 9%. And as a new indicator, we're going to introduce ROA. ROA currently stands at 2.6%, and this is to be brought up to over 5%. in the next 3 years. For fiscal year 2018, revenue of 10 trillion. Well, we're going to start from 9 trillion with respect to logistics and capital and so forth. So it's going to be an increase of 1 trillion in effect. Adjusted operating income ratio of over 8%, EBIT ratio of over 8%. These are committed numbers, and we will be building on these numbers going forward. And net income attributable to Hitachi stockholders is to be over 400 billion yen. So we will be implementing fiscal year 2018 midterm management plan. And as part of the global campaign, we're going to use the catch copy, "The future is open to suggestions." What it means is that our future is open. And depending on the ideas that we may bring forth, our future can be changed. So the future is open to suggestions. That's going to be the catch copy. Hitachi, through collaborative creation with our customers and partners, we will be creating new values in a society. Thank you for your attention.
We will now like to open the floor for Q&A. The floor is now open. Question. I have two questions. In your presentation, you mentioned that for low-profit business, you are going to be discerning the viability going forward. Now, to increase or decrease, to strengthen your business portfolio, what are you going to dispose of, and what is going to be distanced with lower capital input? Is it just for low profit, or how are you going to discern between the core and non-core, according to your view? This is my first question. Answer. You have rightly stated this in terms of how we're going to assess the non-core and core, as well as profitability. Those both will have to be considered. In terms of core or non-core, I mentioned that by bringing to bear the IT technologies, we can enhance the added value. This will be considered to be our core business, where IT can be utilized. But in terms of products, where it is better to promote as an individual product, that will be classified as the non-core business for us. In terms of the low profitability business, within these businesses, there is also a classification between core and non-core. For even if it's a low profit, it could be a very important product for us. Then we can establish partnerships with others so that the business can be strengthened. This is the approach that we will be taking. Question. Are you going to be talking about a specific business in the classification? Answer. I cannot give you specifics. But for all of our business areas, we will once again scrutinize going forward. Now, question. Regarding the resources that have been obtained, I understand that you are going to be engaged in investments for M&A for growth. The current M&A market seems to be overheated today. And it may be difficult to acquire attractive business at a reasonable cost. It does not seem easy. On the part of Hitachi, in competition with others, what is going to be your focus so that you can realize deals which is of high cost performance? amongst the investor community, they are saying that when cash is generated, it should be returned to the shareholders by doing share buybacks. There are some in the investor community that hold this view. So how can you have an M&A with appropriate returns? Answer. With respect to the M&A activities that we have been involved in, I believe there is room for improvement. Because what is going to be important is post-merger integration after M&A. Whether we have been able to realize this according to plan is questionable. And in terms of investments for growth, I mentioned that we are going to consider 1 trillion yen or so. But in terms of products, as well as for the front business strengthening, are the areas where we'd like to allocate resources. In other words, with the digitization, social innovation business is going to be very important for us. To generate cash is going to take time. Upfront investment is going to be very significant. So we have to combine this with products as well, so that we can establish a portfolio where cash can be generated. In the coming 3 years, in the midterm management plan period, we will be conscious about the cash portfolio in pursuing M&A opportunities. And once M&A is conducted and we acquire the company, post-merger integration will be done thoroughly so that the profit can be generated accordingly. Inclusive of what we have done in terms of M&A activity so far, there is soul searching that we have to go through. Thank you.
Any other questions? A question. Thank you for the presentation. I have 3 questions. Question number one. Strengthening the front, you said that you will be increasing the staff by 20,000. Looking at the human resources in Japan and the fixed cost associated with that, in the next midterm management plan, what is the expectation of fixed cost increase? I don't have detailed numbers with me. Answer, I don't have detailed numbers with me.
Well, currently, the answer is that for Japan, 85,000, overseas, 25,000.
An answer, just to give you the rough idea, strengthening the overseas front is going to be key, in my view. In April, fiscal year 2014, for Japan, finance and public businesses front needed strengthening. And 4,000 people were brought to the front from one of our affiliates. Finance, fintech, my number started and so increased by 4,000. But for overseas, we did not do much. So in order to drive our global business, we need to strengthen human resources overseas. That is the basic thinking behind. Regarding fixed cost is likely to increase with our solutions business. And so as I said, when I discussed smart transformation, we need to look at the cost structure. In terms of gross margin, in terms of SG&A, what are the levels we are achieving, we need to take a look at. And with increased staff, SG&A is going to increase with expansion of service business. But the question is, how much gross margin can we secure? And that is the kind of control we need to perform as we look at the cost structure. Question, thank you. My second question. You said that you will be reducing the number of layers in management in your organization. Have you set any qualitative targets for that or quantitative targets for that? Well, I hope you will wait because we're working on it. In April, what we did is as follows. I myself and the CEOs of the business units. We now have a direct line between the two. There's no one intervening. Group heads, company heads used to intervene between the two, I myself and BU CEOs. But we now have established a direct communication line. We can engage in direct talks. So layers in BUs, there are departments and sections. There are many, many layers. And what is important is that we need to understand what's going on the ground. And that needs to be conveyed accurately to the head of the BU. And so in view of that, we have given instruction to reduce the number of layers in the organization. And work is underway for that. What question? Thank you. My last question. Adjusted operating margin of 8%. Based on IFRS, in terms of operating margin, what's going to be the level? Answer, I don't think there's going to be much of a change. Well, question, it's going to be based on IFRS. Adjusted operating margin is different from IFRS-based margin. So in terms of IFRS, what's going to be the number? Answer, we do not disclose that number. Thank you.
Question. I have three questions. First question is regarding revenues of 10 trillion yen. Is there going to be impact of M&A and group organization impact? Are those factored in? In terms of group reorganization, in the past meetings, you said that a certain achievement has been made. But once again, what is your view in terms of group reorganization? Now, answer, regarding 10 trillion, it is inclusive of the M&A. And regarding basic policy, let me outline the following. Currently, Hitachi's growth rate, CAGR basis, is 3% as in terms of business as usual. So nearly 500 billion is organic growth. But for the remaining 500 billion, will be covered through M&A. That is our basic view. Regarding group reorganization, I cannot give you details today, but on a timely basis, we will be strengthening the front. And in line with this, further group reorganization may take place. Second question. Now, you have the front platform and product realignment, and the objectives have been set, targets have been set. But in terms of the starting point, the level of last year, can you give us some information about what was the starting point? If that cannot be provided as information, which business is going to improve? Answer. I believe there is information. Left-hand side is 2015. But if you look at the product numbers, the logistics and capital is included, transport systems is and capital is included. So we have to reduce that by 1.1 trillion. And we are going to increase by 500 billion. Furthermore, it's not a segment that we are disclosing, but in terms of front, a product to be acquired is being is overlapping, and that's about 1.1 trillion. So inclusive of this, I think you can understand which area will grow. In terms of profit, the front is about 5.6% in terms of operating margin. To increase this to 8%, what must we do? That is what we're thinking about. So on an individual basis, we are trying to accumulate the numbers one by one. Now, question, you said for front is 5.6%. What about the platform and products? answer. Platform is 8.4%, and product is 5.5% in actual terms. But the platform scale is still very small. So it is strengthening the front that will have a more significant impact. Question. Regarding a numerical target, although it is not included, what about the ROE target? You said that how are you going to return value to the shareholders, inclusive of share buyback? But in terms of ROE, what is the level, or what is your thinking behind the ROE? Answer. ROE and ROA are both important. In short-term perspective, ROE will suffice, inclusive of share buyback, to enhance ROE. And shareholders' capital to be enhanced is a short-term perspective. But in terms of social innovation business, it has a time horizon of 3 to 5 years. And shareholder capital inclusive is what we have to do in terms of looking at the asset efficiency. That is the reason why we are emphasizing ROA.
Any other question? I see a hand in the third row. Please go ahead. Question. I have three questions I would like to ask. Question number one. With respect to shareholder return, I would like to seek clarifications. If possible, dividend payout ratio, can it be given? Or a more specific idea about share buyback. You said investment of 1 trillion yen. Given the level of free cash flow that you are generating, it's not a small amount if you are to conduct a share buyback. So just to clarify, if you could give us specific ideas. Answer. We haven't decided yet, and with respect to share buyback, we will be making timely decisions if necessary. In terms of dividend paid by Hitachi, dividend payout ratio has been in the range of 20 to 30% thus far. And that is because each time we make a dividend distribution, we've had needs for M&A and other plans, and that is why it goes up or down. But even if the payout ratio may remain the same, we would like to increase the absolute amount. If the bottom line profit can be raised, our dividend can also be increased, and I think that's one of our missions. Question. So the dividend payout ratio may be maintained at a similar level, but the absolute amount of profit is going to be increased? Answer, yes. And question, my second question is about horizon. In recent months, we have not seen much news about horizon, but seeking partners, if partners can not be found, what's going to happen, we've been wondering. And I think it's going to be a risk for your cash flow and business. So if you could share with us your current thinking, is it being reflected in the next midterm management plan or not? Answer, just to give you the status regarding Horizon right now. ABWR, we're trying to get type approval, and four stages are involved. We've completed up to the third stage, and we're into the fourth stage now. In fiscal year 2017, we will be completing all the stages. So it's on schedule as of today. And what you mentioned, is that Horizon is a utility company, and what are we going to do with it? Because it's an operating company, what are we going to do with it? I believe that was the question. And we have to strengthen Horizon, inclusive of our negotiations with the UK government. We need to decide the strike price or to secure shareholders. So it requires a lot of efforts. So the top management of Horizon, the CEO, as of the 1st of May, Duncan Horson, he used to be the top person at a Canadian nuclear company, and he's quite famous in the industry. He's appointed as the CEO, and he will be negotiating with the UK government. And with him on board, I think the value of Horizon can be understood better by people. And we will disclose the shareholding relationship and other aspects. And so roughly in fiscal year 2018, the future direction of Horizon will be set. Question. So Hitachi will be leading the effort to move to the construction phase. Answer, we will be engaged in construction ourselves mainly, but the construction company and the operating company will have to be separate with each other. So power generation, power distribution, the company doing that, and the company making construction will be separate. Question, I'm asking about the investment for construction. Answer, investment for construction. It is being reflected in our midterm management plan this time. Now, question number three. The operating margin target is a committed target, you said, I believe. And when you say commitment, that you're committed to this, I would like to ask what it means. Depending on the economic conditions, things may go well or other things may not go as planned. And regardless of that, by changing the portfolio, you would like to meet the target. Is that your intention? Answer. Well, as to the changes in the economic conditions, there are those that can be anticipated. There are those that are unexpected. But within what we can anticipate in the next 3 years, in terms of profit, we believe that we can attain a margin of 8%. In China and other regions, we've shown the revenue targets. And there are, of course, certain underlying assumptions. China is not going to change all of a sudden drastically. And in Europe, many events are ongoing. Brexit, EU withdrawal, and refugees. And to the extent that we can anticipate, we have come up with those revenue targets and other targets. But if there's going to be a more drastic change, it could provide us with an excuse. But we're not thinking about that right now. Question. Thank you.
Next question, please. Question. I have also three questions today. First question is regarding the Hitachi Capital and Hitachi Transport Systems that have been reorganized. These are areas Hitachi Capital can bring to bear fintech. It could have been made 100% subsidiary, but why have this reorganization taking place? Answer, regarding the logistics business or Hitachi Transportation Systems, we are very knowledgeable regarding IT, but in terms of logistics, it isn't as if we are experts. For B2B, that would be logistics, and B2C, Sagawa is a very is a specialist company. Therefore, in order to strengthen the logistics business, to integrate could mean stronger business for us. But as I have mentioned, the logistics and settlement e-commerce will be combined and integrated, and the Lumada platform can be provided so that a more efficient logistics business can be promoted. This is where a relationship can be established. And that is the reason why we have maintained the 30% stake in terms of the reorganization. Question, what about capital? Answer, regarding Hitachi Capital, for Hitachi Capital's business, how we can expand the business is going to be very important. Because if Hitachi Capital is on a loan, having assets of 3 trillion and 1 trillion could be for Hitachi solution business. And in terms of revenues, we are 300 billion. That is how contribution will be made. But if we pursue the social innovation business globally, it may not be enough. Project finance as well as leasing will have to be considered as well, which means that a wider collaboration is warranted to grow the capital business. And that is the reason why we have come to this decision with MUFG. They are proposing an open platform with other mega banks, inclusive of global banks, to have an open platform utilizing project finance. Is such an advantage for us. That is the reason why we have decided to maintain the 30% stake in Hitachi Capital, so that we can have a bearing in terms of governance. There is advantage here. Question. Regarding internal adjustments that was mentioned earlier, the numbers that have been presented earlier, I've made calculations, that's 800 billion altogether. So in terms of profit, what is the adjustment? Where will the adjustment reside in terms of disclosure? For product business, because it's a product, it could be procuring, and there could be other procurement from others as well. If you have too much vertical integration within the product, open innovation could be limited. So what is your view on this? Answer. As you have rightly mentioned, in terms of how we disclose our accounts, as such that in terms of continuity from 2015, on the 13th of May, we have provided information by the original business segments. But regarding disclosure going forward, we are going through adjustment now. We are trying to coordinate this currently as we speak. Now, when we establish the front, we will look at Hitachi products as a first look, but we are not obliged to purchase from Hitachi. I've told this to the front people. If it is different from, by a factor of 1.5 times for Hitachi, then it will not be competitive to use Hitachi products. No, we are trying to be able to sell on an individual basis products going directly to customers. You can see this here. That will not be posted for the front. So for product business unit, on a daily basis, they will be able to post this on their own, and profitability can be enhanced accordingly. But once there is a competitiveness, and once they can sell the products on an individual basis, it is likely to be procured internally as well, because it is in line with market prices. So this will generate competition. Question for the product people. Are you saying that the dependence on Hitachi should be reduced? Is there a target set accordingly? If product improves, or if it's not strong, as in the case of Hitachi Capital as well as transportation system, is it possible that you will lower the stake for the purpose of efficiency? Answer, we've only just started this. For the front, it is important that on a first look basis, they would look at the products, and they have to say at certain levels will have to be provided in terms of purchasing from Hitachi. But as you have rightly mentioned, outside sales percentage to enhance competitiveness may be one option that we may consider going forward. Question regarding the discount rate. For the case of Toshiba, in terms of nuclear power plant, they said 11%. For Toshiba overall, by segment, it's about prevailing around 5 to 10% in the case of Toshiba. In the case of Hitachi, for long-term business as well as short-term business, you have both. There is a high volatility, low volatility business. What is the discount rate that you are assuming today? Based on IFRS, you have to look at the present value. This will have also an impact depending on the discount rate. But what is the range and by segment? for social infrastructure, what is the discount rate? Can you give us any hints?
Answer.
Inclusive of discount rate is not we are focused on, but in terms of overall social innovation business, present future value is higher, and present it will take time to generate profit. But on the other hand, for product, it can generate profit higher. So that is the overall viewpoint we have at the moment. But if we look at the time span of 3 years, we will be emphasizing cash. Question for Hitachi, with IT business, you had restructuring and the discount ratio of 5% in terms of calculation. And against this backdrop, so far domestic, but overseas business is increasing, especially for emerging nations, and social infrastructure business is going to increase in emerging nations. That means that the risk-free rate will become higher. So the IT overseas could be 10% compared to 5% domestic. So it may be appropriate for 3 years. But when you have long-term plan, the discount ratio on the basis of IFA should be considered. So far, could be looking at operating profit and extraordinary losses in profit. That could be the CFO's responsibility. But now, the business unit will have to look at extraordinary losses as well, which means that the long-term discount rate is going to be very important. Can you offer more hints?
Answer, we haven't gone so far in terms of discussions in this area. Depending on the regions, the strategy implemented will have an impact, and time span of 5 years or 10 years will have an impact as well. And the size, the footprint of the business will have an impact as well. All these factors have to be taken into consideration.
We are putting forth the front platform products. But there are mid to long term initiatives are limited, and for social infrastructure, it is should generate cash within 5 years. A nuclear power plant is an exception, but in the case of railways, from 2017, cash will be generated from that business. So 2016 is going to be a difficult year for us in terms of cash flow management. However, it's a span of 5 to 6 years. But during nuclear power plants, we have to have look at the time horizon of 10 years.
Question, last question.
Now,
in terms of assets, it's 10 trillion. What is the breakdown between the three areas?
Answer, we don't have that number with me.
Any other question? I see a hand in the middle, a gentleman. A question. In 3 years' time, you plan to make an investment of 1 trillion yen. What are the main areas of businesses you will be making investments in? At the macro level, for the front 60%, products 30%. I think that is the rough breakdown. Question. South Africa's thermal power business. You're having difficulty with Mitsubishi. How are you going to seek a breakthrough? And what's going to be the impact on your business performance?
Answer, for that, just to give you the facts, 31st of March from MHI,
we got a claim of 379 billion. We said that we cannot pay that. That was the answer we gave as of April 7th. I think you know that. And we're now negotiating what to do with them. So I can't give you details. But there are just two things I would like to say. Number one, the amount that we need to reserve for that. In fiscal year 14 and fiscal year 15, we have already made a reserve through appropriate accounting approach. So today, we no longer have to post a reserve for that. In terms of accounting treatment, we have done what needs to be done. That is our understanding. And second, which is important, negotiation is underway. So I can't tell you what's going on in terms of negotiation. But with MHI, Mitsubishi Heavy Industries, so We want to work together on a global basis in thermal power generation business. That stance is shared between the two. So in that regard, our relationship is going to continue. And we would like to continue seriously engaging in the negotiation. And once we come out with a direction, we would like to make an announcement.
Next question, please. I have three questions. Regarding the front BU organization has been set up this time. Out of the 12, energy solutions have preceded others. So for the preceding business unit, what kind of results have been achieved so far? What are the challenges besetting this business unit? And how is this impacting the new organization from April 1st? The one that went ahead was to deal with the power market deregulations. So we wanted to strengthen the grid business for us. That is the reason why it preceded the others. In terms of the system, it's a wide area system. And we are trying to establish the system after order has been received. This is one result that has been achieved. There are many challenges, however, for the grid-related area. Grid engineers must be strengthened. Otherwise, we will not have global competitiveness. The grid world has a significant demand globally. Renewable energy, such as wind as well as solar, are making inroads. And that means that it will be distributed power source, and the frequency is not stable. That means that we need engineers to deal with this issue. In Hawaii, there is a transition to solar from doing away with the thermal power plants. And the electric vehicles will be able to store energy for their homes, which means that the virtual power plant is what is being realized. So to have a full understanding of this, utilizing big data and also forecasting the weather for the next day, and also to estimate the power that can be generated from solar as well as wind, and how much discharge is going to be made will have to be calculated, which means that we need more grid engineers. And we would like to secure these grid engineers globally. Question. Regarding the new BU, what are the indicators you are going to be utilizing to manage these business units? Is it margins or is it free cash flow? Answer. The challenges besetting the BUs differ from one to another. For the business units with low profit business, they have to implement countermeasures against this. That would be the first and foremost challenge for them. For railway business, where it is on a good trajectory and M&A has been conducted, and the business size is growing, means that in terms of 2016, cash flow will be the issue. Because upfront investments have been made, plans have been constructed in the UK as well. The IEP trains will be running from 2017. So cash is not being generated yet. This is the challenge besetting this business unit. Depending on the business unit, I will set the challenges one by one, and that will be the performance indicator. Question. For 2018, operating profit margin and EBIT is 8% each. So you have set aside the companies from consolidation, and it means that the EBIT should become higher. But why is that not the case? Answer, yes, you are right. In fact, if anything, we want to increase the EBIT ratio. But we don't know what is going to happen. So that's the reason why we have said 8%. There's no deep meaning in this.
Any other questions?
Yes.
see a hand from the person next. Question. I have two questions. Question number one. GE and Siemens, these global competitors, compared to them in the new midterm management plan, Hitachi's originality, Hitachi's uniqueness, how is it laid out? What's unique about Hitachi compared to your competitors? Answer. Now, looking at the business indicators in terms of revenue, I think the greatest difference is in cash flow. We have yet to catch up with our global competitors. We would like to make effort to catch up with our global peers. One of the great differences, I believe, is that be it GE or Siemens, they're focused on products or hardware. And when it comes to software, big data analysis, they're trying to absorb that as well while focusing a lot on hardware. And in the consulting industry, their main business is IT. And they're trying to move toward social innovation and products. Now, Hitachi, as I said earlier, OT, that's for control and operations, and IT and products and systems. We can do all of them. Now, when we go to the customer, we can ask what their challenges are. That's consulting service. And if they say that they want to improve profitability or drive sales, if those are the challenges of customers, then we can come up with solutions to address the challenges. For example, improving the efficiency of logistics or EC settlement system can be installed. We have finance business. And what to do with import systems? Well, most of the solutions can be provided from our group. And where we're lacking, we can always utilize our partners. So that should be the difference that sets us apart from GE, Siemens, or IBM. I can use the orchestral analogy. We want to be the conductor. And all of that is going to be built on Lumada so that we can work with customers. That's the kind of approach we would like to take. And I think that is one of the biggest business differences with our competitors. Question. And it's hard to ask, but in the last 2 years, your share price performance has not been very good, which I believe was affected much by the macroeconomic conditions. And now that you're starting your new midterm management plan, with respect to your share price performance, what's your analysis on the current level of the share price? And in the next 3 years, what is the kind of share price performance you are expecting? To the extent that you can comment, please. Answer. Well, depending on the surrounding economic conditions, our share price may change. Here in Japan, we have a negative interest rate policy, and yen is strengthening. There are so many uncertainties going ahead, and they affect our share price. So amid such circumstances, share traders, the people who trade in stocks, their mindset is affected greatly by the economic conditions, regardless of how well we perform as a business, because the people who engage in transactions mindset change, our price is affected. And we need to go out to the front and provide more explanation to the market. And with today's meeting, we may not be able to cover everything, and not everything may be convincing to you. So we need to go out and visit people to explain more. Otherwise, we will not be better understood. Hitachi as a company perhaps is difficult to understand. So I need to go out and visit the market, as well as other people, investors, to explain more so that a better understanding can be gained. Thank you.
Next question, please.
Question. I have two questions. First question is regarding the midterm management plan. Appliance, white goods, how is that positioned within this plan? That's my first question. Answer. Regarding consumer appliance positioning, if appliance, well, it's in fact included in products, and if profit margin is going to be 3 or 4% low level, I think we have to rethink that business. However, appliance is closest to the lives of people. Air conditioning has sensors. Now it will look for the leg area so that the warm air can be provided specifically. So it means that they will be able to understand the situation of people, the physical condition of people as well. It has an impact on the confidentiality as well. But if it is digital consumer appliance, that can have this impact is something that can be viable, and would like to discern this within 1 or 2 years going forward. Quality of life can be improved. Question. GDP flash figures have been announced. It's 0.4% and for annual basis 1.7% for January to March. And it seems that capital expenditure for companies have declined. What is your viewpoint on this? Answer. Regarding the 1.7% growth is something that we accept as happy news. But the substance is more important. Capital expenditure, you mentioned that it was negative. I'm not sure, but because of the strong yen, exports have improved. And I don't know how much improvement has been made in personal spending, but mentally, people do not have the mindset that the economy is improving. So the management of companies are curtailing capital expenditures because of the uncertainty going forward. Same for personal spending, consumption as well. Now, base up has been made and income has increased, but they are still concerned about the future. That's the reason why they are not spending. Currently, regarding the numbers of 1.7%, we're very happy, but we have to watch this further. Otherwise, we cannot be fully confident about the improvement. But it is my earnest desire that the improvement is being made.
Any other questions?
Question. I have three questions I would like to ask. Question number one. Earlier, you mentioned this in passing. GE is more focused on products. Predix and Lumada, comparing the two, what are the differences, I wonder? At GE, centering around Predix, they have industrial internet, and they have a turnover of $5 billion. And they're hiring geniuses in Silicon Valley, and they're to triple their business soon. So Lumada's revenue, inclusive of that, what's your situation? How are you going to grow that business? And another part of the question is that GE has internet consortium, and there are major members included in the consortium, including Hitachi. So partnerships with consortium members, colleagues, what's happening there? Answer. With respect to Lumada, we are anticipating only 300 billion yen in sales in 3 years' time on a standalone basis. The greatest difference is that Lumada can be connected to Predix. It can be connected to Bluemix, Industry 4.0, Solitas. It can be connected to everything else. That's how it's designed. So it encompasses data. Well, for clients who do not like that, perhaps Lumada is a better choice. we have large targets, but Lumada is an open platform. So we're not thinking of generating a huge revenue out of that. The solutions business that's to be generated in the front, that's to be improved more. So $5 billion by GE, I think they're focusing more on analytics, and that's all included, right? Jet engine service business is also included, I believe, in the case of GE. So in that regard, Lumada's revenue on a standalone basis may be limited, but in the next 3 years, we would like to build the base or platform so that together with the front business, we would like to grow. Question. So we're not trying to be too profitable or on a standalone basis. Understood. Question two. On page 25, you have given us your revenue forecast. If possible, it could be operating margin or EBIT ratio. What are the current numbers? Overall, it's 5.6%, you said. In four respective areas, how much is to be achieved? And based on that, overall, you said 8%, that's the target. The speed of improvement, what's going to be the speed? And 540 billion this year, and are we going to improve by 130 billion so that I can reach 800 billion in 3 years' time? 19.3 is the current or latest SG&A. To what extent is that going to be brought down? So what's going to be your thinking behind overall profitability? Answer. There are details that we can disclose. There are others we cannot disclose. As of 1st of June, each business unit will have an RR meeting. So in that meeting, if you could ask the question. And as I said earlier, SG&A, in the last midterm management plan for 2015, it was on the order of 19%. Gross margin 26%, and so products and service-related business, SG&A, respectively, would be different. And in terms of service, starting from fiscal year 15 up to 2018, it could be increased because we're going to increase staffing. And through such initiatives, it may go up, meaning that gross margin will have to be substantially improved. So for each business unit, details are being hammered out. So please do ask that on the June 1st meeting. Question, how is it going to be improved? At what speed? Answer, well, 8% is the target. Well, there are geographic conditions and other conditions. And given what we can forecast, we're committed to 8%. Question, well, what's going to be the process? So are you going to achieve it in the very last part of the 3 years, or are we going to do it gradually? Answer, there are uncertainties. Well, we 9.6%, set those numbers. And because there are uncertainties, we need to reach fiscal year 2017 to be more certain. Question, I would like to ask about risk management. For the term that's ended, it seems that there are losses being incurred from discontinued businesses. And you don't seem to be worried too much about your discount rate, which is a concern for us. Boeing, for 787, they have to sell 1,300 aircraft. And I think it's the same with your railway business. You're focused on railway business. So given that, why there has been some successful business areas in the past, and what's going to be done for the future? Answer, I think you're talking about thermal power business. And the order Hitachi plant business areas that had strength. And I wonder how many others are in the wing. Answer.
There are areas where we have strength. There are other areas where we do not have strength necessarily. In terms of thermal power business, we decided that we are going to be discontinuing that. The last time, we had 3 units remaining, and construction was still underway. And so we set up a reserve so that it can be discontinued. And we brought the amount down to 170 billion, considering thermal power business. Construction is complete and it's now generating power, but because of the contract that's in place, because of the delay in the process, we have to negotiate the penalty. So we're not adding any construction work, but we're looking at the worst case scenario in the context of negotiation. There's a counterparty, so we can't say much, but the way in which reserve is set up is different from before. Now, the plant business, once construction work is involved in a major way, it becomes hard to manage, inclusive of civil work, engineering. We can't control everything. So we have stopped receiving new orders because we may lack strength. But there are one or two sites that are still ongoing, and we would like to closely monitor them. We will be discontinuing over time, but there are ones that are still ongoing. There are about 3 in the Middle East. 2 are done. 1 is to continue until 2017. So we will be closely monitoring the one that's still ongoing. And information from the ground is not necessarily conveyed to the top management. That is the problem. So I said that we need to have better communication with the people on the ground. We need to reform our business so that the top management can gain relevant information to come up with speedy decisions.
Next question, please.
Two questions. There was a question regarding GDP earlier, and there is management are struggling whether they want to make investment or not because of opaqueness going forward. For your company, are you being prudent in terms of CapEx? Answer, regarding CapEx, my view is that we should do where it is necessary. But within the plant, there was eagerness to invest within that plant. We want to do away with such a thinking. We have to look at the group perspective. There are some plants that has excess capacity, so we should reallocate the work accordingly. So we need to have a more overall approach. And if there is a shortfall, capital expenditure should be promoted. I am not reluctant. Question, you said that there is concerns on the part of management of the company. So what is the concern? Answer, if capital expenditure is made, there is concern whether export is going to increase because foreign exchange volatility could come into play all of a sudden. So that there is uncertainty that managers are concerned about. And in terms of personal spending, we need more revitalized spending. This will have a positive impact on mentality. But so far, there is opaqueness in the outlook going forward, which is leading to reluctance in terms of making investment. Question, second question. Brexit is being considered currently, and this is also a factor of uncertainty for the world economy. What is the possibility of this? According to your view, you also have a business in the UK. If Brexit occurs, what is going to be the impact on Hitachi as well as for the Japanese economy? Answer, 23rd of June is the date of the referendum. We have to watch this very carefully. But the view of Hitachi is as follows. UK, as a member of the EU, has been the basis of our decision to establish a plant in UK. We wanted to develop a business to Europe after production in the UK. So we are against Brexit. Britain breaking away from EU. We are against that. But it's useless to think about this based on hypothesis. So we have to wait until the 23rd of June to see the result of the referendum. If there is Brexit, is it going to have an impact? Answer, after they break away from EU, the subsequent relationship between the UK and EU will have to be considered. So when they start to break away, there could be others following suit. So we have to look at the overall impact. We have to think about the issue of refugees as well. So it seems that Europe, volatility, uncertainty in Europe is the problem, inclusive of Brexit as well as refugee problems. We are concerned about a possible increase in uncertainty in Europe overall.
Any other questions? I see a hand from a gentleman in the middle. Question. I have three questions I would like to ask. So in the last midterm management plan, I would like to ask, Chairman Nakanishi and President Higashihara, how do you share roles and responsibilities between the two of you in terms of implementing the plan? The two of you headed up by the effort, but what were the commitments made by the two of you? Answer, well, we had good understanding with each other. Mr. Nakanishi used to be the CEO, so the management of all is seen by Mr. Nakanishi. The ultimate decision, inclusive of decisions for M&A, are made by Nakanishi. That is the role that he has. And for the decisions made, as a CEO, I will implement the decisions made by Nakanishi. Roughly speaking, that is how we share responsibilities. Question, thank you. So for the year ending March 2016, for revenue and operating profit, or rather, for revenue, you did meet the target, but when it comes to the bottom line or operating margin, you have not been able to meet the targets. So, what was the greatest reason behind the shortfall? Was it the plan itself? Why were you not able to meet all the targets? Answer, I don't think the plan itself was inappropriate. So the target of over 7% was appropriate, I believe. As was asked earlier, the cost of loss came out larger than expected. That was a major factor. Have we understood that better, it would have been better. And foreign exchange rate volatility was very large because yen depreciated so much. It was hard to see whether or not we were generating the numbers based on our true strength. It was hard to see that. So regardless of how the yen fluctuates or the cost of loss, project management, by having better control over them going forward, where we could not attain the profit target, we would not repeat that in the new midterm management plan. I myself and each BU's CEO will have a direct line of communication, as I said, and the line between the BU CEO and the people on the ground will be shorter, closer, so that the voices from the ground can be conveyed properly to the top management of each BU. And the top management will have to take a proactive approach in collecting information from the ground. And I think that will be key for the success of the new plan. Question. I think you've answered most of my questions, but they're having questions raised about share buyback and to attain the profitability target. It seems that there's some sense of distrust in the market, and as a reflection, such questions are being asked. So as you said, even with the changes in the environment, you will continue to make effort at collecting information, voices from the ground for proper decisions. Well, of course, there are many things we need to do. And inclusive of that, we have to attain the bottom line target, and we would like to concentrate our management on that.
Next question, please. We are running out of time, so the next one will be the last question.
Question. I just have one question regarding operating profit margin. More than 8% is the main target for you in this midterm management plan. Regarding the front and business units, and you have the four major regions overseas, what is going to be the driver for achieving this 8%? Please elaborate further. Answer. In terms of regions, I think it's Europe. 300 billion upward effect can be expected in the railway business. From 2017, service will be provided. IEP business will be included. And it's a 27.5 years service contract as well, so it should generate a profit in a steadfast manner. So profit will be generated without fail. In terms of the IT area, where it says the finance, public, and healthcare, I have already talked about the issues in terms of project management, but information business has changed. Information telecommunication systems profitability has been improving significantly. Project management phase gained. Thorough risk management has proven to be successful. And that is the reason why nearly double-digit profitability is being attained. By implementing this thoroughly, we should have a good revenue source. Now, industry-related products, Hitachi industrial equipment profit is still limited. About elevators and escalators, bill management profit is high. Automotive system is revenues of 1 trillion, and operating profit is around 7%. Therefore, these should be the main drivers for profit. And thank you very much. I would like to bring this meeting to a close. Thank you very much for your participation.